All right, buddy. Batista's on its way. This television has a poison on its breath. This counterculture, both the wicked lives and death. It makes my eyes bleed every time I turn around. How will they all feel when I bring them to the ground? And I said, yeah, I'll walk for miles inside this pit of danger. A place where no one follows me, I walk alone. Yeah.
Let's kick some ass.
Let's get our fucking shit together and kick some fucking ass!
That was George Gadd with the Batista song.
straight from a... He's still in New Orleans.
He's literally on the street drinking right now.
I was going to say, does George drink? Because I had a feeling he was... When I wrote him, and he was like real excited right away.
Yeah.
And he was like, what do you want to hear? And then before I could even answer, he was like, how about Batista's song?
Yeah. He's just sitting out... Batista-ing.
Yeah, on the streets of New Orleans. It's Monday. We have the Raw after WrestleMania out in the background. I got to watch my phone because Laura's going to be landing, so we got a lot of distractions today.
Yeah, we're good.
Let's do the intro. Hey, guys, welcome to Kickin Ass with Jesse.
And Andy.
Brought to you by American Barbell Club.
Go buy their shit, www.americanbarbellclub.com.
ABC Strong.
They have a bunch of shit on there that you can get to make yourself stronger.
Yeah, working out needs. They got... Their clothes are my favorite, the hoodie that I wear every day, and some sweatpants and some t-shirts, and they're good shit, man.
They got wraps, too.
knee wraps,
they
wrist wraps.
Stuff, man. I need it all. I need to wrap my entire body at this point.
Yeah, I get gimmicked up hard before I work out now. It's kind of pathetic.
Nah,
let's also mention that...
Rate and subscribe.
Oh, yeah. We haven't said that in a while either. Yeah. Guys, rate and subscribe us on iTunes. That helps a lot. And if you're listening to this the day it drops on Thursday, April 12th, if you are in the Los Angeles area, we are going to be at Joey Ryan's Bar Wrestling tonight. At the show starts at 9 p.m. on Thursday.
It's late.
Yeah, it's awesome. For a Thursday, that's badass. The address is 4725 Main Avenue in Baldwin Park, California. Presale $20, $30 at the door. He hasn't announced any matches yet. He told me he does that kind of like last second.
Yeah.
But pretty sure it's us and our buddy Nate, Brody King, in a six man.
Good.
That's going to be awesome.
I'm going to fucking kill someone that day. My last wrestling match in about 5 months.
Yeah, it's the last time we're going to get to see Butch in a wrestling ring till probably the end of summer.
You're going
to
see me as a devious heel manager.
With some sweet chronic fucking street clothes.
Just wait, dude. I'm going to be all chronic'd up. And you will see me managing my first ever wrestling match.
Yeah, that is Saturday, April 21st. We are going to be in Brooklyn, New York for Outlaw Wrestling, which is run by good brother Bull James.
Yep, it's 4 days after my surgery.
Yeah, four days after Andy has major shoulder surgery. He will be managing me to the ring as I take on Mike Verna.
There you go. Saturday, the man of steel.
It is at 275 North 8th Street in Brooklyn, New York. Bell time, 7:30 p.m. So come on out. April 21st, if you're in the Brooklyn area, and see us live and fucking in person, man.
And that day, the Blade will be killing someone, because that's what we do. We fucking murder.
And Andy might throw fire. We'll see how that goes.
It all depends if Amazon comes through before then.
Yeah, with the good shit. So, it's the Monday after the biggest weekend in pro wrestling.
Yeah.
Like I said, we have the Raw... From WrestleMania, the Raw after WrestleMania on in the background. I don't want this to turn into like a Raw review show, but I mean,
no, not at all. But this is a big,
yeah.
The Monday after, like this weekend, I think the Monday is bigger than
a lot of times. It's been better than WrestleMania.
Yeah.
If Bobby Lashley comes out, we're gonna have to stop podcasting for a second and just put it over the whole time.
But yeah, I mean, I started off the weekend watching Matt Riddle's Bloodsport. I paid for it.
Yep.
Bought it. If you're hearing it here, $9.99.
Support of the brothers.
Yep. Yeah. I can't remember what. It seemed like every single website was selling it.
Really?
Yeah.
You said the quality was good too, right?
Yeah, it was awesome.
A lot of people said that.
I gotta say, I don't like the context. I know some people did. I hate the fact that there was no ropes.
Yeah.
But it did seem like Bloodsport,
which is cool.
Which was awesome.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah,
what I mean?
I mean, like, I'm not being a hater, but when I didn't watch it, but I had a hard time envisioning what, like, you know, if that would have been one match with no ropes, but like the whole show,
the whole card.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was weird, but. But that, I mean, Walter, who did Walter wrestle on that? Walter wrestled Tracy Williams? No, Tracy Williams went against Eddie Kingston.
Yeah.
Eddie Kingston, hot shooter.
I was going to bring it up. Like, Eddie's a good buddy of mine, both of us, and he'll be on this podcast sooner or later. Eddie, you wore a singlet to the ring.
I would love to talk about that.
God bless you, man.
I loved his gimmicked up knees, too. His knees looked like they were more gimmicked up than mine.
Like all kinds of like straps and braces.
It was cool. It was cool.
That's great.
Yeah. That match was good.
The big one was Suzuki and Rick.
Yeah, I mean, I like Loki, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
And obviously he's like the originator of like 100
strong style.
Yeah. 100 other dude styles.
Yeah, a lot of guys have borrowed from Loki.
Yeah. So I wasn't like that pumped about that. I kind of don't understand the Hitman gimmick either. Like, I like him being like the like little kick ass, like ripped up, wearing like he wore like the bike shorts, like the
yeah. He always changed it up.
He
did bike shorts. I know personally, like Loki basically did that because, as we just said, everybody was borrowing / stealing from him, so he's trying to stand out.
Dude, and I get it.
Yeah,
you know, but
I think that was supposed to be the whole gimmick, is just, you know, Riddle's kind of like the new guy, and Key was like the originator.
Of course,
you know what I'm saying.
I just
also get well, Loki, because did you see his video? He got like an MRI and his neck's real banged up.
Oh,
so,
Jesus.
Yeah, and he's hurting, man.
Oh,
so.
I'm definitely not shit talking him. I just wasn't excited about that match.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
You know what I mean?
A lot of people said when they got Suzuki, it was like, holy shit, God, this is.
It was like everything. Like, as soon as I saw Suzuki, I was like, that actually perked interest in me. Like, the blood sport actually, like, perked interest in me. But also, like, the context is so strange. Like, it was just like,
yeah,
it was really strange.
It was only tap outs and submissions, right?
Yeah. And there was like there was some weird things, like the Severn match.
It was him and Dickinson, right?
Yeah. It like Severn got up on him and started like ground and pounding him, and he stopped the fight like it was gonna be done.
Yeah.
But then they kept fighting.
Yeah.
It was really strange. And then Severn ended up winning. And then the next match, whoever it was, Nick Gage versus Thatcher.
Yeah.
Nick Gage, like, ground and pounded Timothy Thatcher out the exact same way Severn got pounded out.
Yeah. And that ended
it. It was really strange. Yeah. It was just strange.
It's like blurring the lines of MMA and pro wrestling, especially when you take out the ropes and all that stuff. It's just like I wouldn't try it because it would look like shit.
Of course, yeah.
Like, you have to be really, really good at it. And I think it's cool. Like, I know Dickinson, and I guarantee he had to be super stoked.
Oh, he was probably just geeking out.
Yeah, work with Severn. That's fucking really cool.
I loved that like Nick Gage was in it.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. The interesting matchups, like Nick Gage and Thatcher.
Yeah,
it's a cool gimmick. Like with the just like Janela Spring Break, it's just all interesting matchups.
Of course, yeah.
You know what I mean? Now all I saw from Spring Break was PCO.
Yeah, well, we watched the first match, and
the scramble.
Eli Everfly. I don't know if I can name everyone.
Yeah, it was DJZ. There was a lot.
DJZ, Teddy Hart.
Yeah.
So
I actually got some numbers today.
Tony Deppen.
Tony Deppen. And Spring Break pre-sold 1,000 tickets.
That's awesome.
It's fucking crazy, man. He had a really good house, dude.
Good for him.
Yeah. And like, I mean, and then like you said, like, because it started over an hour late. And it was
something like that, man. Like, yeah. I turned it on.
I know it was supposed to start at midnight. It didn't.
I turned it on at 1 and was expecting to, like, rewind back and watch some things.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, wow. They were still showing ads. And then I hit up Morgado, and Morgado was like, dude, it's just running ads, like, right now. So it didn't start until about, like, quarter after 1.
Yeah.
But I don't, you know, if I was there and, like, I mean, I don't drink, but, like, the environment is just insane.
Yeah. Like, props to Joey on 2 years in a row of just putting an awesome card, like, you know, drawing an awesome house, like, that's creating so cool. Creating an awesome environment. Like, it's just fucking, it's awesome.
I mean, just, that's like, in my mind, that's what wrestling needs, too, is just, like, you have to understand that, like, the fortunate thing that we have is that we can just do something completely different.
Yeah.
Than normal life.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's, I think Joey takes that to, like, the other realm. Like, Joey is a little nerd from Jersey.
Yep.
He created a persona that he is this badass.
Yeah.
Bad boy.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's, and like, I, honestly, like.
But he's good at it.
He is a hardworking man. Like, that's, the, he works so hard.
He hustles.
And that is, like, to me, like. Like, I always talk about it because I'm 40 years old. I love looking at younger people and being inspired by inspired by younger people.
Yeah, that hustle and work hard.
It just is like, it's the coolest thing in the world.
That was one last year when he made like a promo video and like Scott Hall came out of like a genie bottle and was like a genie. Like, one of the Young Bucks like tweeted and was like, this is my kind of wrestling. Like, it's just different.
Fun,
yeah,
man.
It's fun.
And it's fun.
It's all the shit we grew up watching, and it's just, it's fucking awesome.
And that's
the,
I think that's
the cool. It's like when guys like Scott Hall and shit like that play along, it just makes it
that
much cooler.
But if you watch a wrestling match, right? Like, if you watch a wrestling card,
yeah.
If it was all dudes hitting the ropes, just slamming into each other.
Yeah, if it's all the same shit.
And they're just staring at each other, and then the guy goes, hit the fucking ropes, and then that guy hits the ropes,
and then
and
they
bam,
get into a strike exchange, and then there's false finishes. It's, hey, yeah, everything
and
can't be the same. Yeah.
You do 10 matches of that, and that's my favorite style.
Yeah.
I would be like,
entire card.
Zonked out.
Yeah, you got to have fucking variety.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I'm right there with you.
You know, that's like the best. I think that was like the best thing about when I was a kid is like, obviously, like, we talked about this the other day, like, the Hillbilly Jim, to me, did zero for my life.
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand why that guy's in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
Like, just because he was an older dude, like, he wrestled in the Golden Age or whatever like that. Okay, cool.
That's, like, the way I always think of it is just, like, even to, like, non-wrestling fans, when you say Hillbilly Jim, they know who he is.
Yeah.
And, like, he talked about it too. He was, like, one of the biggest selling, like, figures.
Yeah.
And... yeah, we don't like. I don't want. I don't want to talk.
Like, a bunch of there was probably a bunch of those pressed.
I don't want to say. I don't want to talk about the Hall of Fame too much.
Of course, it sucks. Like, I will say this about the Hall of Fame though, and I said like Ric Flair's acceptance speech.
Oh, there's been some awesome.
Made
ones.
Me cry.
Yeah,
Jarrett almost had me.
Yeah,
there was a point where Jarrett almost had me.
Yeah, Jarrett's was awesome.
And I can't.
How about that awesome story he told about Ahmed Johnson wrestling a fucking house show?
It was awesome.
And during the double down, Owen Hart getting on the headphones and telling him to play Ahmed's music three different times during the match.
It was amazing.
And he got to the back and was just furious.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, that's Jarrett was fucking on point. And like we said, like for the year that that guy has had, it was really cool to see.
Yeah, man, that was just seeing him in the crowd too, like. During NXT was like rad. Like it was just, I'm glad. I hope that guy got his like life straightened out because he really is like one of the greatest.
Yeah,
in my mind,
he's done a lot. Like, like you said, not besides wrestling, like, you know, bringing up young talent and all that shit.
Dude, NXT or not NXT, TNA at around like 2003, 2004, 2005 was wrestling.
Yeah,
and at that point in time,
he was the dude in charge of everything.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's wild.
Yeah. And that takeover was just
awesome.
Like, probably to my, like, I don't know. I just like Tommaso and Gargano again. That's like, I text Tommaso and told him, I was like, dude, that was one of the best finishes I've probably ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
Like, it might be the best.
Dude, they get, I don't know what it is about those two, but they bring like this movie drama into their matches.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It's like, it's only the type of drama that you feel when you see like a TV show that you're like invested in or a movie.
Yeah.
And you, like, I don't get that from like normal wrestling matches.
A lot of that comes though too from like, you know, me and you couldn't go do that this Thursday at Bar Wrestling.
No, not at all.
Because that angle has been dragged out
of
for
course,
a year and TV time and video packages.
That's all part of what I'm talking. You know what
I mean?
Exactly. That drama of it is,
and that's
like,
why they were able
shit.
To do that. They took total fucking advantage.
Dude,
of
it was insane, man.
Yeah, like, it was just a fucking fight, and it was fucking awesome.
And like the we talked about, the only thing that was like messed up about the whole thing is that Gargano went for that like reverse Rana.
Oh yeah, that's...
and it was like a little misstep.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Tommaso got power bombed onto concrete. Like, you know what I mean?
Like honestly, was like, come on, man. Who cares, man? Like, yeah. If anyone critiqued that,
like,
you know,
it's just like, I don't know. To me, like Gargano, it's just like he just had that fucking that match with Almas, that main event. That I literally, it has to be one of the top five matches I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, it's awesome.
And then to go in right into doing this, it's just like, dude, what the fuck? Yeah. But I feel big. A big part of that, I'm just guessing here, was Tommaso put some more pictures up on Facebook today.
Yeah.
Of like him backstage, like warming up and stuff. And the one was he was talking with Shawn Michaels.
Oh.
It's just him and Michaels. Like, I think Michaels was like an agent and probably had a lot to do with that as far
but
as
still,
like, as far as the storytelling and all that shit. You know what I mean?
Two performers though that are just.
But that's such an awesome combo. It's like, like they're so good, and then they have fucking Shawn Michaels helping them put all that
just
shit together.
There,
it's fucking, dude, that shit is so awesome.
Ember Moon just debuted, by the way.
Oh, right. Not that fucking missed.
Yeah.
I turned around and Kurt Angle's talking to Braun Strowman.
Yeah. Where's Nicholas, though? and then, you know, we have Mania. There's Nicholas right there.
Yeah. Oh, I love it.
You know, that NXT, let's talk about the other matches. Because, like, Tommy won the title.
Yeah, our dude won the title.
Yeah, Aleister Black.
I love that he just fucking, like, broke character and was, like, smiling and, like, holding up the title.
Yeah,
like,
man. You know, that was, like, a cool fucking thing, man. It was fucking awesome.
He ruined his whole gimmick.
Who cares? Yeah. Didn't bury him at all. You know what I mean?
No, that was fucking great.
It's so cool, man.
Am I saying that right? Almost.
Almas, yeah.
Yeah. He's so good.
Yeah. I
and
like
and
the
that
fact
and that ch- and the fucking God, I fucking know I'm gonna butcher her name.
Yeah.
His valet is so her timing is so good.
Yeah.
Like fuck, man.
Yeah. That they're whole, just awesome. And
yeah.
Like,
it's great.
I love the fact that he comes out. He does like the thing where he comes out in his old mask.
Yeah.
And takes his mask off.
It's
on
fucking
the thing. It's
badass.
So cool.
Super badass.
That
That like opening ladder match was just 45 minutes. You're looking at the TV and shaking your head.
Yeah, I think No Way Jose is debuting.
Oh yeah,
that's a bummer. that was the what was it? The other was there a tag match? Tag match was like good. I like the fact.
Well,
loved,
then with Roddy,
I loved the heel turn.
Yeah, spoiler alert. Roddy turned heel
awesome.
At the end. Joined. Undisputed Era.
Yeah, I thought that was great.
Yeah, match was sweet.
And just the fact that like Cole just goes out and gets powerbombed through a table and that's it.
Yeah.
Just like sold that because he had the ladder match.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Which I mean,
came out with your favorite gimmick, the taped ribs.
Oh, my favorite gimmick. I will always root for a guy with taped up ribs.
Yeah,
it literally does nothing.
It's the best.
It does absolutely nothing.
I fucking love
it. It's great.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we could do an entire podcast on that ladder match.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say on gimmicked ribs.
No, I would love to do that.
We could talk about DDP had him for 2 years.
that ladder match was
It was so long and so good, man. Like,
it was psycho.
You just, when you thought it was like, oh, they're probably getting ready to go home, like, they just kept going.
Yeah.
Fucking A, man.
It was just crazy. And, like...
Like, this is going to make me sound like a complete mark, but, like, Laura and all the Impact Knockouts had like this VIP like bar party thing that night.
Yeah.
And like EC3 came and I was like, he was there? Like he got put through like three ladders.
Yeah,
like I literally thought he was like he'd be like too hurt to like do anything.
Nope. He's partying.
Yeah.
What I was gonna say about him is like he really didn't do anything in that match.
He got some offense, but mainly he took insane bumps.
He was sold it. He was selling everything.
Yeah.
And that entire thing. Like his whole like He wasn't in there to like stand out, even though he stood out.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
He's like, always been good at that.
And then Ricochet, like, I almost feel like they like let Ricochet, like he got like two big things in.
His first thing was a springboard
holding,
shooting star.
But they're like, all right, man, don't give it all. You know what I mean? Like go out there, do a few things, but don't give him at all.
He
you know
killed
what I mean?
It, man.
It was insane.
He makes wrestling look so easy. It's insane.
That we were talking about that one. There's like a section of the match where he like just takes a bump on a ladder.
Yeah.
And makes it look
like it's so it, like he was like playing or
yeah,
something.
Yeah. It's just like boom, and he bounces off.
He's like selling his ass off.
Dude,
like,
at one point in time, Lars Sullivan and Damo play catch with him.
Oh yeah.
They
yeah,
like yeah. One beels him across the ring and then one beels him back.
Yeah. Yeah.
So cool, yeah. Man.
Just beeling him everywhere.
Yeah. So yeah.
Yeah, Takeover was bomb.
We watched a few fringe things. We watched Laura wrestle Taya.
Oh yeah, yeah. On the Twitch.
Yep.
Yeah. That was Friday night. Yeah, they did the Impact Lucha yeah. Underground joint show.
Yep.
So we streamed to watch that during the Hall of Fame.
We also watched the Chris Bros versus Scott Steiner
and Teddy Hart.
The honestly, tag team of Scott Steiner and Teddy Hart.
And Teddy Hart. Yeah. Steiner just randomly just kept coming in the ring.
It's so funny because he's definitely not as big as he used to be.
But he still looks
insane. But compared
insane.
To everybody else that was in the ring,
yeah.
He looked like he was 8 feet tall.
Yeah.
And like 8 feet wide.
And just looked like he was ready to kill somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the whole time.
Moving
oh, back. And Warren in NWO Wolfpack cut-off cool. shirt.
Cool. I'm yeah. pretty sure he wasn't even in the Wolfpack. I feel like he was always white.
I think you're right.
Yeah. But he decided in 2018 he's switching over.
Yeah, he was definitely two-sweeting people on his yeah. way out after
he's
the
so
match.
Cool, that was awesome.
Teddy Hart hit a whole bunch of finishers in the opening couple minutes of the match.
His shine was just everyone's finisher.
Yeah.
It was insane.
Yeah, that was fucking, that was something.
Yeah.
And then, I'm trying to think what else we watched besides WrestleMania.
That was it. We could yeah. talk about WrestleMania.
And then, I thought WrestleMania was great.
Yeah, I honestly, I looking back on it, like, Asuka and Charlotte.
It was really good.
It was match of the night
like,
for me.
It was really good.
It was crazy.
Yeah,
man.
it's not like a, what was it? Was that the year before when it was there was Shane McMahon versus AJ? And it was like the yeah. second match on the card, so you almost forgot about it.
Yeah.
And it's like same with them. It was early in the card, but like it was dude, really, really
that
good.
That match was awesome.
And I liked how it was just she just slapped on the fucking figure eight and
yeah.
she tapped. Like
yeah.
they didn't go to it eight fucking times.
Brody like, texted me like while that was happening and he was just like, dude, he's like, this match could kill on any indie show.
Oh god.
Any big indie show.
Absolutely.
Like it was legit.
Everything
really
yeah,
good.
So crisp. Like I was super into like Charlotte's entrance. She did the same thing.
Yeah.
But just the way like she like fucking cartwheels on the ground and then she like slides in and like she just yeah. looks so confident and
yeah.
like a fucking professional athlete.
She is,
and like it's dude, she should just
down,
run through everybody.
She's the greatest. I think she's the greatest female wrestler.
She's right now or like ever?
I would say ever.
She's good, man.
She's unreal, man.
She's fucking awesome.
It's just like she has everything down.
Yeah.
And just she knows herself and she knows her moves.
Yeah, she really like figured it out
yeah.
after time.
And it's really good and you could tell she's definitely not like scared anymore. Like there was definitely like a point in time when she first
oh, yeah,
started
she was,
like,
she was green and stuff. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Now she's just so fucking confident.
Exactly. And that's like in her just in her face. She looks so confident
yeah.
and fucking
I kinda wish that like Natty I wish Natty was like going through her prime.
Yeah,
see, like
now.
Charlotte, like how it is now, where like you know when Natty was coming up, women's wrestling wasn't the way it is.
It was just
now.
a bad timing. Yeah. Yeah,
and like, oh man,
they did have an awesome match at NXT
for sure. They
yeah.
100%. I'm just saying that it would be awesome to have them go at her. You know what I mean? Like they were
thing
both.
Is,
just
I think Natty still could
100%.
You know what I mean?
She still could.
Yeah.
Who is No Way Jose wrestling?
Oh no.
I don't get
I think he would debut tonight.
No.
Oh, that's...
Is that JT Dunn?
For a second, I thought it was, but it's definitely
yeah.
just an indie brother.
Yeah.
Wow, man.
But, yeah.
Okay.
We got some debuts today. We had Ember Moon and...
Straight to No Way Jose.
Yeah.
Waiting on Bobby
I almost
Lashley,
just said,
hopefully.
Okay, Tony. I'm way more into Okay, Tony. He just hit two moves on that dude in one... yeah, WrestleMania was something else, man. Like,
it was good.
I'm kind of getting,
like, I don't know why. Like, I keep like on the way here, I just kept thinking I feel like we don't even need to get into the whole thing of just how like, you know, everybody like judges it and like,
of course,
like,
yeah.
Oh, and you, like, you know, just it's like you were saying before the show started, we were talking about how they were talking about should AJ and Nakamura be the main event, or like Brock and Roman? And you were like, hey, how about you paid to watch, like, they'll give you the product they want to.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
It doesn't really matter.
They're not going to listen to you.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like, just you can say all you want. And you think that, like, a dude in Topeka, Kansas is going to change, like, Vince McMahon's mind and be like, oh, fuck, man, he's right. We should probably listen to this guy. I've only been doing this for 40 years.
I only built this whole thing. Yeah, it's from the ground up.
And like, the thing is like, if you don't like it, then don't fucking watch that match.
You can make
any match your headlining match.
Pretty much. Yeah, you're right.
Just walk away.
The show's over. Turn it off.
Yeah.
Like Brock and Roman. Like, I watched a grown man fillet open another grown man's head with his fucking elbow.
Yeah. Like, that match was like really dying for me at that point. And then it was
it started coming down, but then it was just like, dude, like, I mean, fuck, man. To like, you know, also remember, those guys are fucking main eventing a show that started at like 5 o'clock. Yeah. You know what I mean?
This is the thing too, though, is like, that creates more wrestling. So like, I think that's what everyone's like, oh, the payoff. Oh, my God. Oh, no, the payoff is the fact that that man splayed open that man's head.
Yeah.
And unlike when he did it to Randy.
Yeah, they
like
kept
Randy
going.
Just kind of like disappeared after
the match.
That.
Yeah.
But he didn't show up. He took like 3 months off like that. Like Roman, now you're going to get more wrestling.
Yeah, it's just going to create more.
Yeah, and it's like if they... So they didn't have the match.
And he kept wrestling. Like,
yeah.
Like I was saying, it was like, man, they better fucking... He's not going to, like, last much longer. Yeah. Like, you better, like...
But they didn't have the match they had 2 years ago.
No.
But...
They can't, though.
They're
I mean?
Going to have that match.
Yeah.
It's going to boil up to this.
They could do... there's a lot of different things.
And that was, like, everybody kind of complained about the
AJ.
And
everybody thought that Roman was going to win because they thought Brock was on his way out to go to UFC. Yeah. And it's like... Dude,
everybody thought that like that the AJ match was like the AJ match was kind of like boring it because they were expecting what they did in Japan.
Yeah,
and it didn't happen. But then that heel turn.
Yeah,
everyone went, oh, okay, that made the match.
Exactly,
it's insane because I mean I don't remember anything about that match other than that heel turn.
The heel turn, yeah,
and it was awesome.
Yeah,
it was
real awesome. Yeah. But yeah, just I mean I don't know, man. Fucking brothers are out there busting their ass. I did want to say this too about I'm rewinding back to like NOLA and Spring Break and all that shit. But like, I just want people to fucking appreciate the fact because I mean like I think of this like you know we said like DJZ was on the Impact Lucha Underground combo show, and then directly after that he was on Spring Break that started at midnight. And I know he ended up that day, he wrestled 3 matches that day. And like, you know, and he's not wrestling just these like easy, like good brother fucking tag matches, like, you know, hip toss, arm drag, get it again. Like, it's dude, like these guys are fucking busting their fucking ass. Like that's an insane schedule. Like, you know what I mean? Like think of like some of the matches, like tag matches, like when we did the fucking tag match with Danny and Tarek, and then if we had to like do that again, like in an hour, like in a couple hours at another show, that's a fucking stressful day, man.
I'm still in.
What's that?
Break my neck.
And then it's like, you know, and then like, you know, but I mean, plus, well, now I'm just gonna go off about Z. Like, props to DJ Z too. He just went through all the fucking stomach surgery and everything, and it's like, you know, he's probably worried about getting hurt again. Like even and like Pentagon. No, he wasn't on Bloodsport, was he? I'm thinking of him versus Nick Gage.
That was in Pentagon,
Nick Gage was Spring Break. Yeah. So it's like, you know, he's not having these. He main evented the fucking Impact and Lucha Underground show, and then he fucking works Nick Gage like an hour or two later on Spring Break. It's like these are fucking badass like main event type matches. Yeah. Like, dude, like some of those guys, their schedule. I remember Sammy Callahan did it like the year before. It was just like the amount of matches that they're having and the quality of matches that they're having, it's just like, fuck, dude.
Yeah,
that's a lot, man. I really hope people appreciate that shit.
I don't know who it was. Someone dropped that they wrestled 5 times in one day.
Was that this year?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I thought it was DJZ.
He could have. I know he said he did 3 matches in one day, and then of course Z's a like young partier, and he went to Wale Mania the day before, and he said he got 3 hours of sleep, then had those 3 matches, which to show my age, I asked, I was I asked Puff, I was like, who's Whale? He goes, yeah, oh, it's yeah. Wale. Yeah. I was like, what's Whale Mania?
Someone came up to me, they're like, oh, we got to get you guys involved, man. You and Whale, like, Wale.
Yeah.
And I did the same thing. I was like,
who's Whale?
I don't know who this dude is.
I looked him up on Twitter. He's got like 9 million followers. Yeah.
Like, sorry, man.
I think he's just a wrestling fan, and he did it like last year, too. Mm-hmm. I remember hearing about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think they might have done two Whale Manias. I'm not really sure. Yeah. Bennett, the hip hop guy, just fucking laughing at us. Yeah. I mean, we can go back to wrestling, but I wanted to talk about Friday too. When we went up to Rochester.
Oh yeah.
We did go out. Another shameless plug to our buddies. Friday we went to, it's called Pop Rock, in Rochester, New York. It was down, I can't remember the name of the street, like East Avenue or something like that. It was right in like downtown Rochester. But our buddies opened up like a coffee, cereal, video games, fucking wrestling, toys, just like a pop culture store. We went and checked it out on Friday. It was fucking really cool, man.
There were so many, it was just, like I walked in, and this is like props to Colin and Nick, and what's that, Jason?
Yeah.
Like, when I walked in that place, like, when Colin told me about it, Colin Delaney told me about it,
yeah,
I was like, oh, boy, you're biting off a lot more than you could chew.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And then when I walked in, I was like, oh, shit, this all makes sense. Like, yeah. It literally was just, like, literally perfect.
Yeah.
Like, that place is perfect. It's only going to get better because they still have a whole other wing.
Yeah, they haven't really opened
yet.
They're
doing. Yeah.
We played a Nintendo Switch volleyball for a good couple hours.
It was nice.
It was real nice. You kept swearing with little kids around.
Sorry, man. I'm a competitive person. Those kids are going to learn a harsh reality at some point. It was, I will be done.
It was awesome.
Yeah.
They had like a Nintendo Switch set up on like a big screen TV in like this like side room. So me and him, and it had like 500 games on it. We found this like sweet like volleyball game where like me and him were a team against a computer volleyball team. What were the names of the teams again?
I don't remember.
Super Mega? Because wasn't that, there was going to
no,
be
No, it was just like
Dick.
Things that were on the wall. Or like the ads
oh,
in the background.
Oh, the fake ads. Yeah.
The sponsorships were Intertech.
Because the one was going to be Super. Dick and Puff's tag team. I think, was it Super Mega?
Super Mega.
Yeah. So we're playing this volleyball game. The one point, like, Andy went for like a slide like save and the like missed, and like Andy started talking about how it hit the guy right in the balls or something like that, and there was literally like a 3-year-old standing right behind him. And then the one time he let out a big F-bomb, and I looked over, like, it was like just in the other room, I could see like Colin was like cashing out like a family, and he was making a face, and he was like, oh, sorry guys, because like basically the swearing, and this woman had her kids with her.
Colin, I'm sorry.
He was cool about it, though.
I'm sorry, Colin.
But it was cool. We got up there like noon, and I guess they had been busy all day, and yeah. That place was fucking awesome. They got that sweet Death Wish coffee from upstate New York that's strong as fuck. And what was that? What was the mixed cereal that you had again?
Oh, well, you had...
I had
the blueberry pancake.
Oh, yeah, blueberry pancake. Well, it was donuts, right?
No, like you had blueberry pancakes.
Blueberry pancake cereal.
And then Puff had the donuts one.
Yeah, it was like
and
a pink cereal.
And I combined
cereal.
Them both.
Yeah, you combined the two. And they were talking about making that an actual article on the menu. Yeah.
They handed the A-dub.
Basically, they had a sweet cereal bar, and it was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, no alcohol there, just fucking coffee. Oh, they have like energy drink cocktails where they make their own fucking energy drink shit. And cereal was really cool, man. It was really good.
It was really cool.
Yeah, but then I also wanted to mention, what was the name? Dogtown? Was that the name? We decided to get midday garbage plates, which is, because garbage plates is a Rochester thing only, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Pretty
much. Yeah, do you want to explain? You could probably explain a garbage plate.
Garbage plate is literally exactly what it sounds.
Yeah. And he's also like, eating, what are you eating right now? Like mango chips?
Dried mango. Sorry, guys. Trying to hit the gym. Maybe see the movie Blockers. I don't know. After this.
Gotcha.
Got to carb up a little bit. Garbage plate is basically like either hot dogs or hamburger is your base.
Yeah.
And then a potato. That's like the base.
Yeah.
So you're either going to pick like home fries, sweet potato fries,
potato
french
salad.
Fries. You can. That's the thing.
Yeah.
A potato salad is just a topping.
Oh, okay.
But
That's the base of it. Then you can do like, you can do like baked beans. You can do like a meat chili, like no beans, like meat chili, macaroni salad, potato salad. It's literally anything you want.
Yeah.
To put on there, but like the base of it is usually just meat sauce, potato, protein.
Kind of.
And then like one weird thing, like macaroni salad.
Yeah, but the, I'm pretty sure the whole idea behind the thing is, like I said, it's called a garbage plate, and it's just, you know, fries and all this thick fucking greasy shit, because you're supposed to eat it at like 2 a.m. when you're like just left the bars, and like we ate it at like 2 p.m.
I don't go to bars, man.
Exactly. And then Andy ate 2 of them.
Yeah, I was fucking hungry.
Yeah, like two. He finished one and he was like, I'm still kind of hungry. I was like, I mean, I honestly was too, but I was like, if I get another one, I'm going to eat like barely a quarter of it and be like, okay, I didn't need another one.
I ate 3/4.
Totally. Oh, I thought Dogtown, I think was the name of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was like right down the street from the Pop Rock coffee place. And Andy just housed 2 garbage plates.
I was hungry. Yeah, it was fucking awesome.
Mine was, I had fucking sweet potato fries, fucking 2 cheeseburgers on it, beans, like a whole bunch of shit, man.
Yeah.
You had, because I'm not big on macaroni salad. You had macaroni salad,
dude,
I think.
I'm only into my dad's macaroni salad.
Okay.
But the mixture of that and the beans is so fucking good.
Yeah, I can get behind that.
Like a little
that.
Creaminess.
Yeah.
To it.
Yeah, beans are fucking legit.
Rub them.
And then we went straight into Ready Player One, which we've already, like, feel bad because we have already talked about it on the podcast, but I hadn't seen it yet. That was your second time seeing it, right? And I also feel weird putting it over so strongly because I fell asleep twice during it, and you fell asleep. You were definitely like old man snoring in the theater.
It's okay. I knew it.
Fresh off of 2 garbage plates, just snoring.
But I already saw the movie, so it really didn't matter.
I knew you'd already seen it.
It didn't matter to me. Just hanging with the boys, man.
Yeah, just there for a good time.
Yeah.
The place was called Tinseltown. It was like this gigantic movie theater in Rochester.
Dude, we had to get up super early, too.
Yeah, we left.
We got up at like 8:30 this morning. Was that your house at 10?
Yeah, we left at like 10 in the morning. Plus, of course, it was snowing super bad.
It's supposed to snow again tonight.
Great.
Fuck this place.
But, yeah, so I feel like, you know, it was a long day, so sorry I dozed off a couple times. But Ready Player One was so fucking good.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I think you already said this, but like, it's like if you didn't enjoy that movie or didn't have a good time, you're not my kind of guy, man. Like,
yeah, it's
holy
wild,
fuck,
man.
Like, what? It's so fucking fun.
Yeah. It has a bit of literally everything, like in that movie. Like, there's a bit of everything for everyone.
Yeah, like the storyline is itself, but then there's so many fucking pop culture references.
Yeah.
And fuck, man, it was so fun.
Morgado
so cool.
Said cheap pop the movie.
Well, I didn't want to get into Morgado's fucking dog shit fucking review, but I love movies like when you leave, like when the movie ended, you're just like, fuck, that was so fun.
You're super stoked.
And so, yeah, you're just pumped up. Like,
yeah.
It was so fun,
it's the best, man.
And then it means, like, because now I want to watch that fucking Buckaroo
Banzai.
Yeah, Buckaroo, which I asked Mark and Eugene, the owners of the gym.
Yeah.
Eugene hates it. Because I was talking to him about that. I was like, he's like, Buckaroo Banzai. Eugene hates it. And Mark loves it.
Yeah.
But I've never heard of it before.
Yeah.
I want to check out Buckaroo Banzai bad. Like, there's fucking, like, Duran Duran references, just fucking everything, man.
Dude, it's Buckaroo Banzai is like, it's a gem.
Yeah.
Don't listen to Eugene. It's a gem.
Yeah, I do want to see it.
Yeah.
Ready Player One was so fucking fun, man.
Yeah, I
can't recommend it enough.
Every character, every person in that movie, like I know that like right now, like it's, you know, TJ Miller's getting shit on, the guy that played I can't remember his name.
I don't remember from the movie. He's one of the heels.
Yeah. He's getting like shit on right now, but he's awesome in it.
Yeah.
Like
real awesome.
The bad dude is amazing.
Dude, he like, I think I wanted to say that and I didn't, like the actor.
Yeah.
Is like the perfect heel.
Yeah.
And then like the fucking avatar of him in the game was so fucking cool.
It looks like Shazam, But like a dickhead Shazam.
Yeah, with like a Clark Kent haircut, yeah. And like, dude, he like, and that guy, he's played heels in other movies, and he's it just because he has almost kind of like a lisp.
Yeah.
And fuck, man, he was really good.
That real fake fake teeth.
Yeah, just like a super sleazy, like corporate fucking asshole.
Yeah, he's just a suit pig. you're a suit pig. You know what I mean? It's a guy that's just. He's just his life is just putting that suit on, just shitting on people,
treating people like shit.
Yeah. Yeah. I thought that movie was awesome. I thought that I loved the fact that his like best friend ended up being like a black woman.
Yeah,
it was awesome.
Yeah, it's dude.
We're giving the whole movie away.
Like, I feel like this. Okay, spoiler alert if you haven't seen it yet, but like. For me, like, sometimes spoilers actually make me want to see a movie.
For sure.
Like, this is the perfect
nothing
spoiler.
Nothing has ever been spoiled for me.
Just, like, the fucking, the one avatar that walks up is Goro from fucking Mortal Kombat with the four arms.
Mm-hmm.
And then a fucking alien rips out of his chest.
Yeah.
And it's just like, dude, they just combine the coolest fucking shit of all time.
Yeah.
Into every, it's just, it's fucking... I don't know, man. If that doesn't make you want to see it, I don't know.
Yeah.
It's fucking great.
It's awesome.
It was so fun.
And then I've heard only good things about Blockers.
Yeah.
Like, I heard Blockers is, like, supposed to be the funniest movie.
Yeah. Like, I haven't seen a trailer or anything, and I want to keep it that way.
Yeah, I haven't seen a trailer yet either. I just read that one thing about South by Southwest where they said that, like, people were literally on the ground crying, like, and laughing.
We did also see A Quiet Place, which was fucking...
Oh, dude. A Quiet Place is, if you want to just be creeped out.
And you got to, like, I feel like it's one of those movies, like, because the whole gimmick is quiet, obviously. Yeah. Like, it's super fun to go see, like, in a theater.
Yeah.
Because it's, yeah, the whole quiet gimmick. Yeah. And it's
well, they kind of give you triggers, too, though. So, yeah. Like, when you're in there, your senses get triggered because they want you to hear that noise at the certain time.
Yeah.
Like,
and jump at a certain time.
Oh, man. It is... That it's everything I wanted that movie to be, and then I'm so glad that John Krasinski guy got the Stephen King stamp of approval.
Yeah.
Stephen King made like a tweet about it that was like, A Quiet Place is literally the perfect movie or something like that. And then like John Krasinski was like, it was just like stuttering like in his text or whatever.
It's not a Stephen King book or anything, is it? He just put it over as like a really good fucking movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which,
man.
I mean, that's, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Like,
that's like Eddie Guerrero coming back and going like, great match tonight, man.
Yeah. You're a really, really good wrestler. Exactly. Yeah. And that makes complete sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was fucking Ready Player One. They had the whole fucking Shining sequence.
I didn't know.
They mentioned it in there. Like, Stephen King actually hated the movie The Shining.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I feel like I kind of remember hearing that, but.
Yeah.
That,
but Stanley Kubrick did it. Stanley Kubrick's a weird ass dude.
Yeah, he probably. It's just like Quentin Tarantino hated Oliver Stone's Natural Born Killers.
I told Kev about this. I watched this documentary called Gringo about John McAfee,
which is
John McAfee. You'll remember this.
Uh-huh.
McAfee antivirus would pop up on your computer.
Oh yeah,
right. He's the guy that like created like the first like antivirus.
Yeah,
right. But it got like. When the recession of like 1996 happened, he just got steamrolled. Like he went from like having like, I think it was like he had like $110 million or that the government knew about.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like dwindled down to like $4 million.
Okay.
Like the dude just got crushed.
Got raped pretty much.
But the man is a legit just crazy person.
Oh, really?
Dude, it was one of the most enjoyable documentaries I've watched because of how crazy that man is. Like, there was like a point in time where they're like, he's just like on the news, like he's on like Dateline or something like that, like talking, and he's like, yes, I do have 5 teenage girlfriends. He's like,
whoa,
55, 60 years older than that. It's like, man. I have 5 teenage girlfriends. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. They all know each other. Then it just cuts to the 5 girls.
Yeah.
And they're like older now.
Yeah.
You know, because it was a while ago. And they're just like, yeah, John was great to me. It was the first time I've ever been paid for sex.
Yeah.
And like, blah, blah, blah. And then like, it comes out that they were all being kind of like bashful about that.
Uh-huh.
He never, ever had intercourse with any of them.
Oh.
He would put them in a hammock.
Yeah.
And these girls are explaining it. Put them in a hammock, cut a hole out the bottom, and they would just shit in his mouth.
Holy fuck, dude.
Yeah. And they all tell the story. None of them are near each other, not like in the same room. They're all at different places. And they're like, yeah, I would sit in this hammock, and then it would cut to the next girl, and he would like cut a hole out of the bottom. Then it would cut to the next girl and be like, well, and then it would cut to the other girl and be like, I would just shit in his mouth.
Dude.
Yeah.
And was that like a big part of the documentary? Or is that just like, you know?
I mean, he's just, it's, I mean, he got caught for like making a meth lab.
Oh, fuck.
They talked to this chick that worked in the
laboratory.
Laboratory with him. And he just hired her like outright. And like one night, she was like, oh, I'm a little under the weather, I don't feel good. He fucking date raped her.
Oh, man.
I mean, dude, it's insane. And she like left him. And like when she left, he just turned the laboratory into a meth lab.
Fuck. Shit.
And the dude is like, then like someone from Dateline is like went to Belize because he was like just living in Belize.
Okay.
To like interview him. And he murdered a dude. He murdered his next door neighbor. And he was just going, like walking around Belize.
Uh-huh.
He would just put powder in his hair and walk around with like a gimp hand and like a cane and pretend that he was like old. But literally they're talking to like normal people on the street like, yeah, we knew it was John McAfee. Like it was just...
He thought he was like in disguise.
Yeah.
Holy
and this
fuck,
Dateline
man.
Guy, like... The Dateline guy walks up to him in this costume.
Oh, like in the getup?
And it's just like, hey, And he's like, don't speak English, don't speak English. And then, like, the Dateline guy's just like, oh, boy, like, that's John McAfee, like, literally in a costume.
Yeah, a real bad one, yeah.
So they go up in the room, and then John McAfee, like, walks in and, like, blasts off the thing. He's like, you guys, I had you guys. You didn't even know
Holy
it was me.
Holy shit, man.
Yeah. I mean, dude, you got it. It's fucking awesome. Called Gringo. Dude, he ran for president in 2016 after murdering a dude.
Oh my god. Did he go to jail?
Dude, he almost got the libertarian. He almost beat Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson was the guy that was running for president.
Yeah.
Libertarian. John McAfee almost did it.
Fuck, man.
Almost got it.
Where'd you see the
on documentary?
Is that on Netflix?
Oh, dude. It's awesome. When you search it,
uh-huh.
One of the only pictures that comes up of John McAfee on Google Images is him holding a fucking revolver to his head, and he's got fucking tribal tattoos and highlights in his hair. Like, he's like a 70-year-old dude, just with, like, trying to live like a teenager. Like, he tried to never live through. And then there's, like, footage of him, like, walking around, and, like, he just came back to the U.S.
Fuck.
And just was, like, chilling in the U.S., walking around.
Did he go to jail for murdering somebody?
No.
Oh, because he, like, fled the country or something?
No. I don't know what it was.
Jeez.
There's some crazy fucking, like, thing in there. They say that, like, Belize is the place where all rich people who are, like, being... all rich people that get in trouble, they just go to Belize.
Oh.
And U.S. Marshals...
Belize is, like, in a different country, right?
It's in Mexico.
Oh, okay.
Or Central America, yeah.
Okay.
So, all these people that live in Belize, they're just like, oh, yeah, like, up twice a year, the U.S. Marshals will come down and just... They know where all of them are.
Yeah.
They just sweep the entire island cruise back.
Yeah, save on the trans money and just get there. Okay, I've just looked up his picture.
Yeah, that's the one. John McAfee. He's awesome.
Tribal tattoos.
That guy ran for president.
Yeah, fucking like straight like psychopath goatee holding a six shooter to his head.
And they're like talking to him when Dateline actually does the interview with him.
Yeah.
They're like talking to him and the dude is just on something.
Yeah, he's got to be whacked.
It's awesome.
I'm looking it up.
You have to watch
ASAP.
Watch Gringo. It's really cool, man. Like if you don't, like, you know, everyone remembers when they were a kid when the McAfee, like, antivirus thing would pop up.
Yeah, that was, like, the first one. Yeah.
Like, this is the guy. And he's a fucking genius. Mad scientist.
Yeah, I mean, he had to be, like you said, if he created the fucking antivirus.
Yeah.
And then knew how to almost, like, create a meth lab while he was
at it. He did create a meth lab. Dude, he started having, like, they said that it went from, like, he'd had security with him. Because the guy was worth a lot of money. Living in like that country, there's no economy.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like the economy is from foreigners moving there because they have nice water. You know, like they can like go and buy a boat and like cruise around an island.
Oh, okay.
But like the people that live there,
yeah,
it's like, you know, it's kind of squalid.
Just like a free-for-all.
And like this guy comes in with like security, and then the drugs and everything like that just kind of like got him super paranoid that then he just started getting like bad dudes. Like, no, dude, the documentary, I feel like I'm not making this up.
What do you mean bad dudes?
He would just go around and be like, who's the baddest dude here?
Yeah.
You're not making money? I'll give you guns. You watch my back.
Oh.
Like evil people.
Yeah, like I'll pay you.
Like yeah, like if he was like in South Central, he would have like the gnarliest gang members.
Yeah, yeah,
like
yeah.
Dudes who have killed
so,
like,
so they're like on his side.
Then he started calling them hitmen, his hitmen.
Oh, man.
Dude, he's awesome. Like, it is so cool.
Fuck, dude.
Just someone just taking advantage of life.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like,
you know?
It's all like, pretty much sounds like an evil genius.
That's
like,
exactly what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
But,
yeah.
You know, his, like, whatever, his fortune, when his fortune declined, I mean, if he was living in New York City, his money would have went like that.
Yeah.
But you live in Belize.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
He is
like you said,
because
there's no economy there.
Yeah.
So there's like you can't just go there and get a job. But
yeah.
if you have money already,
yeah.
You can just basically live there for peanuts.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, and just
wild man.
Like just cruise around in a boat.
Yeah.
And hire hitmen.
Just wait until you hear his like investments too. His investments are awesome.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He like invested in some like he bought 280 acres in Colorado.
Yeah.
And like made this like. Yoga sanctuary,
yeah,
and like no one went.
You never really followed through with it.
Yeah. So there's like this gnarly huge building,
yeah,
in Colorado, just like
that nothing ever happened.
And like, I want to know what is going on with it now.
Yeah.
Do they make it a Starbucks or something? Like what? There's just a gnarly. I mean, dude, 280 acres.
Is he still alive?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
And he's cool.
Yeah.
He ran for president 2 years
ago. That's
a
good point. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Which means like in another 2 years, John McAfee might run for president.
Maybe
again.
He might just keep trying.
It was really funny. Like I was talking to Hannah on the phone this morning and she was like, oh, what have you been doing? I'm like, well, I just watched a documentary. And my girlfriend lives in California. I live in New York, so the time is a little fucked up.
Yeah,
she still
hours.
Wakes up fucking early. She's like the gnarliest person.
Yeah.
So you know, she doesn't call me until like 11 o'clock because she's just getting up for work and
yeah,
stuff
their
like that.
Time.
Then she's like, oh, what have you been doing? I'm like, well, I've been up since 8. I watched this sick movie about this dude named John McAfee.
Yeah.
He let people shit in his mouth and he was like murdering people. Yo, the movie starts with him getting pulled over in a monster truck. And it's like the dash cam and the dash cam, like he's like, he gets up. He's like 65 years old. And the cop's just like, what do you have on you? He's like, I have, and he's got a really gnarly voice. Like, I have $4,000 on me. And Bob's like, do you always travel with $4,000? He's like, I'm John McAfee.
Yeah.
And the guy's like, yeah, I don't know who that is. And then like, he's taking it out. He's like, do you have any guns? And he's like, yeah, I have guns.
Of
blah,
course.
Blah, blah. Like,
yeah.
It's fucking insane, man.
Dude.
And the dude is just dressed like, I mean, he's dressed like a college kid. Like, he has, like, camouflage, like, cargo pants
yeah,
on.
Yeah,
and
he's,
and
like, in his 50s or 60s,
dude,
probably.
Yeah, it's just awesome.
Uh-oh.
There's a good match on right now.
Wait a minute, hang on.
We have Jeff Hardy coming out right now.
Oh, he's back. Hell yeah.
This is the big comeback, Jeff
uh-huh.
Hardy's big comeback.
And Seth Rollins.
Wow.
Oh!
This is sick.
Business paparazzi.
Yeah, so... Yeah, if you guys did. The movie Gringo, because a movie just called... Gringo.
Castillo, one of these
yeah.
mangoes?
A movie called Gringo just came out about that, like, guy who has to bring the marijuana pill to
yeah.
Mexico. And I missed it. I was on tour the entire
time. I know.
It
already came out, and I'm pretty sure it's probably already gone.
It's gone, yeah.
But it'll be on VOD or whatever pretty soon.
Hopefully, man.
Yeah, that was really good.
That looked awesome. It was the one with, like, Joel Edgerton, Charlize Theron. Right?
Was it her or Cameron Diaz?
It was Charlize Theron, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then, like, just this, like, poor black dude who, like, basically is, like...
With a really funny accent.
Yeah, he's just, like, a grunt worker at a, I'm guessing, like, some sort of, like, office-type job.
Yeah.
And, you know, the high-ups just go, oh, we'll take this guy. hey, we need you to like deliver this to Mexico. And then it turns out that it's like he's going to like the Mexican cartel.
Yeah, it was like medical marijuana or something. Yeah.
Like a pill that you take or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like poor dude just gets kind of thrown to the wolves or whatever.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to segue a little bit.
Okay, that's fine.
We, I don't know how to get into it basically besides saying like, so I used the Fleshlight for the first time.
Oh, wait, that's, wait, hang on, hang on.
I didn't know how to really jump into it.
This is easy. So I posted the picture of, Nina Hartley, and then Fleshlight had hit me up saying, they hit me up saying that they were going to send me a Nina Hartley Fleshlight.
Yeah, because you know like a dude.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, an 18-pound box showed up with, like, I have Joanna Angel's vagina and butthole, Nina Hartley's vagina.
Yeah. And there's, like, a Predator one in there.
The Predator vagina.
It was a big purple alien-looking weird thing.
Sending it to Zach Cannon because his favorite movie's Predator of all time.
Yes!
Yeah, and then like a bunch of like ones. There's like one that's supposed to emulate like a blowjob. Is that the Aviator?
I think that's what I got.
Yeah, I gave Jesse the Aviator because Laura's been gone.
Basically, like, yeah, Laura's out of town. Like, I've never. That was like my first sex toy like extravagance. Yeah. Like, I'm talking like with chicks. Like, I've never done it before. Yeah. So it was like. Like I told you, I was real weirded out for a couple of days, and I was like, I don't know, man. It's
you were
kind of weird. And
kept
then,
asking
like,
questions.
Yeah, I did ask a lot
dude,
of questions.
Dude, I'll tell you what,
I was real intimidated.
I had this thing called the quick shot.
Yeah,
where it's like smaller.
It was like a one use kind of.
No,
or just
no,
like,
it's just small. That's okay. It. So it's supposed to be like travel
thing, this
size.
Thing was like big, and
travel
like intimidating.
Size.
Yeah,
yeah. So like, the tip of your dick comes out the top. And just kind of like you caress it around,
it like just hugs your shaft.
Yeah, so it's basically just like added cool shit to your hand. So if you're ready, if you jerk off with your hand, anyways,
it just has something else.
Now
there.
It just has like crazy, like wet, nice, lubricated feel. Dude, I was like three pumps in and ready to go.
Like, you're just ready to explode.
I almost came in three pumps. It was insane.
Like,
and it's not like I'm looking, like that's like the Nina Hartley Fleshlight.
Uh-huh.
Like it has like a vagina on it.
Yeah.
Right. So it's like you're looking at it and you're like, whoa, that's her vagina.
At least like it resembles.
Yeah, I guess.
Kind of.
In a flashlight.
In a tube.
You know, weird.
Yeah.
This thing doesn't look like it at all. It's just like you're.
Little...
I mean, the one I got you was see through anyways.
Yeah.
This thing is see through also. So it's not like you're holding something that's like, oh man, I'm gonna fuck
like
that.
Like sexual, yeah.
Yeah,
it's like a thing.
This is like something I use for masturbation now.
That's exactly the thing I had. It was like,
cool.
It's big. Yeah, it doesn't look sexual at all.
Yeah.
But like, it works.
Works
a lot.
I fucking told you, man. So, dude, just like WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Right? Like. Vince McMahon's been doing this for 40 years.
Yeah.
These Fleshlight people have been doing it for like 20.
Yeah, it's been around.
Like, they know dicks.
Yeah, they know pressure.
Yeah.
And fucking...
Yeah.
It was, this episode of Tug Time is basically brought to you by the Fleshlight.
Yeah.
They took good care of the brothers.
Yeah, Tug Time is now brought to you by Fleshlight.
Yeah, and I'm just here to say, man, that the Fleshlight works. It's a real thing.
Dude, I was so fucking pumped to send Scotty that picture, too.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I sent him the picture of the box, and he was like, what the fuck is going on? Like,
we
hear him.
Nice t-shirts.
Yeah.
Kev, you didn't do the Barry show. Puff wrestled in a church on Saturday and wore his Fleshlight shirt the whole day.
That's so good. That's my next thing. I got to give Puff one.
Yeah.
He'll never leave.
He did seem like, when because, as I said, Laura's been gone, so the fucking Fleshlight was just chilling on the countertop.
He's like, you gave him the Aviator?
Yeah, he was just like, oh, you got the Turbo Aviator? Yeah. He was so into it.
Should I give him the training one? They gave me like a training one.
I should use the training one. I was fucking blown away.
I think the training one is to like help you suppress your like to like make you last longer.
Oh, okay.
So you're supposed to train.
Oh, so that's like the, okay, training as in sex training. Okay.
Yeah.
He's 21. Yeah, give him the training one.
I feel like he needs a fleshlight. What if I give him the one with the handle on it, though? There's one that has like a bare knuckle, like a brass knuckle grip.
All your fingers go in there?
Yeah.
So you can really just go to town.
Yeah, just hammer it out. Man, I'll tell you what. If I could get all the boys quick shots, I would.
The quick shot sounds
it's
like
awesome because it's
the
just
real deal.
The cleanup is like super easy because it's just like jerking off.
Well, as you said, your prick hole is sticking out the top.
Yeah,
so
but it's just like jerking off.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, but
yeah.
Did the pressure thing kind of fuck you up?
No.
No? Just loosened it, right?
Yeah, it wasn't really like I don't even think I needed to really.
Yeah,
then you made me nervous because you're talking about this pressure gauge and you're like your dick will get stuck in there and I was like what?
Like, so like it's like anything else, right? So like the bottom part like screws, you have to release this like pressure valve.
Yeah,
there's like a pressure valve.
It's just like a fucking top.
Yeah, that's
like
it. Yeah, but if it's all the way off, mm-hmm. it creates a suction. So, like, I don't think your dick would get stuck in it.
Yeah.
I think that it would just be like, oh, shit. Like, you're tugging.
Too much.
Yeah. Yeah, you're getting too much tug going on.
A lot of tug action.
Yeah. But they're fucking awesome.
They're a thing, man.
Yeah.
I remember hearing, like, Rogan say this, too. Like, after you do fucking finish up, and then you feel a little weird. you feel real nice, but then you feel a little weird.
I don't feel weird because it's made for jerking off.
Yeah, that's what it's for.
You know what I mean?
100%.
Yeah. And like that's the thing. Like you got to think that like there's, I would say, there's probably a good percentage of women that are of, I would say maybe like 21 and up.
Uh-huh.
A good percentage of them probably have a toy.
Yeah.
That they use.
I always heard that was very normal.
Yeah.
For chicks.
So, like, you can't feel weird about it because it's like you're just doing what everybody does.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah. Like
just
you said, that's
sticking
what they
your dick in plastic.
Mine's like a jelly. Like, yeah. Basically a jelly.
Oh, that's what the quick shot
jelly
is.
Jelly inside of a plastic tube.
Yeah. Maybe I should. I might romance myself with a. It's like a full guy tonight, not the quick shot.
The big fucking, the big ham hawker, I got. Maybe
I'll do it.
Yeah, it was like, I don't know. It was like, I'm just, like, the mindset of, like, the first time I used it, because it's been twice now.
Yeah.
So, it was just, you know, I was like, man, do I really need this thing? And then, like, I mean, it's
should
nice.
I bring Joey Ryan one? Bring it to the ring, and then when he goes for, like, the... When he goes for
the
fucking the dick thing, I just pull it out and I go, like an offering. Like,
there's got to be something there with it. Yeah.
You can have this.
use this fleshlight instead of my hands.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's definitely something there.
That'd be pretty cool.
That'd be really cool.
I'll pack one.
Throw it in the bag. Yeah.
I'll pack
one. And just, you know, keep it in the box so you can see the fleshlight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hold on. I have an offering. Please don't do that to my hand.
Yeah. Then he just punts it into the crowd and puts your fucking hand on his dick.
He puts his hand in it and then punches me with it.
Yeah. So, yeah, the fleshlight's pretty sweet.
Yeah, man.
It's
tug time, now brought to you by Fleshlight.
It's a real nice rub.
I'll hit brother up about that and see if we can actually get an endorsement.
Yeah, like a real deal.
Yeah.
Like you said, if we can get all the Buffalo Brothers hooked up with fleshlights.
Oh, man. The quick shots?
Yeah. Hacker posted that picture. He took a picture, like, of his shower.
Oh,
and,
yeah,
fleshlight children. He's like, I'm loving all this fleshlight talk right now.
Just wait, though. Now this one's going to be that. Like, Scotty, it's kind of hard. Like, that was one thing, too, is, like, as I was, like, rubbing one out with the quick shot, I just kept thinking of Scotty. Like, not thinking of him, not, like, thinking of his person.
Yeah.
Like, I wasn't looking, like, thinking of his body.
Yeah.
But I was, like, thinking of him, like, man, he was right.
He knows what he's talking about.
Yeah. Then I thought of him spreading his ass. Just kidding.
I just love how, like, he literally just leaves his he's engaged, and he leaves his children in the shower. Like, I use this thing on the reg.
that's
cool.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
So, yeah, I'm glad we got that out.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't really know how to segue into that besides just
talking about it. Do you want to segue into something else?
Yeah, what do you got?
Kev, you got something to tell us? Kev came out publicly.
What's up, man? Yeah.
You want to tell the podcast?
Yeah, come on, Kev, you got big news.
Straight into America. Oh, man. Oh, this is in America.
Straight into the world. Somebody from Australia hit us up the other day.
Because the other day, I don't know if you noticed, I said it on the podcast.
Yeah, did you notice that he said it last week?
No, what did you say?
That he basically said, like, now that you're getting ready to have a kid, and you said something else, and I don't think you were really paying attention back there. Yeah. I was gonna...
No, I think I do remember you saying it, but...
Okay, because I was going to say, hey, I don't know if you want to edit that out or something. I totally forgot to mention it.
We're public now. We're live right now, so here we go.
You're the gender party.
Yep. Yesterday.
Yeah.
On WrestleMania Day, though, because I felt it was a big day, so I might as well just crunch everything into one.
The boy said, yeah, did you do that on purpose?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, they're just like, pick a Sunday, and I'm like, fuck it, I'm doing it WrestleMania Day. I'm going to do it there.
Going big.
Yeah, so, well, Kevin Bennett's going to be a father.
Uh-huh.
To a girl.
Yeah. What is it, like, did you guys do, like, balloons or something? I saw, like, pink balloons.
Yeah, Anna came up with the idea. So.
How does that... Did you guys open something and then the balloons came out or something?
Yeah, like there's like a little video of it somewhere that somebody put up.
Did you know before the balloons came out?
No. Oh, nobody did, yeah.
You and Anna didn't know?
No.
Did they like hire a company for that?
I was gonna say.
We took a box, like she went to FedEx, asked for like one of the biggest boxes they had, and she bought the box, brought it home, and we went to fucking Party City, and then just handed him a slip from, you know, the tech that gave us the ultrasound or whatever.
Does Party City normally do this stuff?
I guess, yeah. I guess it's like their job.
So oh, okay.
We bring in this huge ass box.
Yeah, and then they fill it?
Yeah. So, like, we just went to Target for like 20 minutes. And, we just came back. They had all the balloons in there and whatnot. We did it here, actually, at the studio.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Put it right.
Right in the Sweatbox studio.
Yeah. Yep. And, I got a clap up going and everything. Dude, I was nervous as hell, man. It was crazy shit.
Yeah, I would have been too.
Yeah, because, my whole dad's side, there were never any girls produced. Like, because my grandfather was adopted, so we don't know anything, like, before him. So it was, like, my grandfather had my dad and then, like, my uncle, and they all just produced boys. So all my brothers were, like, making fun of me and shit because my brother just had a boy last year. Everybody's like been waiting for a girl this whole time. Oh, so okay. Like they've been making fun of me, like saying I'm gonna be the first one to do it and break the chain, and here we are. I got a fucking girl on the way. It's weird, man. It's a weird feeling.
That's tight.
It's really crazy. A human, and it's a girl.
A human female.
Like everyone's like, can't wait for you to have a boy, man. It's gonna be a wrestler.
Yeah. It's not, you know, the exact whatever. Opposite.
So, yeah, and then I saw pink balloons come out of that damn box and then almost threw up. It was some crazy shit, but...
Shit got real.
It did. But, yeah, that's what we're dealing with now. So, congrats to me, I guess.
Fuck yeah, man.
Yeah.
Goddamn. Cool. Goddamn. Yeah. Congrats, Kev.
Yeah. But, yeah, that's my story. That was my WrestleMania Sunday.
That was my WrestleMania. It was bigger than just WrestleMania.
We've been keeping that quiet for...
Try to keep it on the down low.
For a while.
Yeah, it's been at least a couple months. Anybody know who's here?
I don't know.
Uh-oh.
Hey, you guys.
Hey, how's it going?
My dad.
Oh, how's it going?
Hey,
we were just talking about the gender reveal party.
How you doing? I'm Andy. Nice to meet you.
Jesse, that's super nice to meet you. How are you?
I think I met you before.
Yeah, probably the wrestling stuff.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Hey, guys.
How are you?
So, yeah.
Yeah, man. Big day. Big WrestleMania.
Been keeping that hush-hush.
Pretty hush-hush.
And every week, I just wanted to give it up.
I broke 1,000 likes on Facebook.
I broke 1,000 likes on Instagram?
Oh, yeah.
Instagram.
Nice.
That's the first for me.
I think the only time I broke 1,000 was, it was like a random Buffalo Brothers, like, shirtless picture. Yeah. Mm-hmm. After a workout.
Yeah.
Yeah, real close up. Bunch of shirtless dudes.
Yeah.
Big
a lot of hairy
likes.
Men like that one.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I never hit 1,000.
Sorry, guys. Sorry, guys.
That's good shit.
I'm bummed if I don't hit 1,000.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't. Yeah, that that's fucking enormous news.
I cooked in the tanning bed before this, and I'm sweating.
I tried to go in the tanning bed, but I neared my butthole instead.
Yeah, gotcha.
Yeah.
I did that yesterday, then tanned it up today. And now I'm sweating.
And I thought I was going to get it done pretty quick. I thought I was going to, like, you know, get that thing all squeaky clean and then be able to hit the tanning bed before coming to the podcast.
Yeah, not enough time.
Not enough time.
A lot of dirt up in there that needed to come out.
No, but I just spent a little extra time up there, you know?
Yeah. Let's talk about Tommaso's tan buns.
Oh, my God.
There was that spot in Tommaso and Gargano, like, they were up on the announcer's table. Gargano, like, hooked him for a powerbomb, but, like, pulled on his tights and just gave him, like, Tommaso, like, the worst wedgie. Like, even the crowd was like, oh! Like, it was just like...
The best wedgie.
It's a real good... And Tommaso just had some real toned fucking...
They were toned and just
super,
hairless.
Super tanned, yeah.
He's like, if he's a Sicilian brother...
Yeah.
He's a hairy dude.
He's all haired out, his armpits, his fucking chest.
He looks great.
But I think he took care of the legs and kept it real professional.
He looks really good.
Real good, man.
Really good, man.
He's zipped up.
Brother. That's like one of the best, like, comebacks.
Oh,
best looking comebacks.
Yeah.
I was impressed with EC3, man. He looked great.
real jacked.
I mean...
The pattern on his tights, the yellow, was pretty stellar, too.
Is there another dude in the WWE that's that cranked right now?
That's a good point.
I think EC3's got... He's the most cranked brother.
Yeah. As far as, like, jacked and tanned.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, there isn't... Maybe, like... Oh, there's that one dude that... fuck, who does he come out with? I think he comes out with Gulak now.
Oh, Tony Nese?
No, there's another suited up guy.
Really?
Yeah, and he was like a male model dude before.
Can he come on 205 Live?
I think he's always with Gulak in pictures, like Instagram pictures and stuff.
Shit. I don't know.
He's got like a normal ass name.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Just like, so he doesn't come on 205 Live, they're just always in like pics together?
Yeah, but he's in NXT, I know that.
He's in NXT? Okay, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, Tony Nese has got to be up there too.
Yeah.
Shit. That's cheap plug there too for, Sheamus has a YouTube channel, I think it's called Celtic Warrior Workouts, and they just filmed, him and Tony Nese just filmed an episode at the gym here in Buffalo, Reps. Check it out, they do a tight leg workout. Yeah, Nese is strong, man.
Yeah.
Strong in his shape. EC3 is like you. He's big on fucking deadlifting, powerlifting, squats. Even with his like bad back and shit. That's all he does, man. He's good at
bad body is just in general.
Yeah, I think that's because he always fluctuated impact. Like he'd be really, really, like for a while he was like really, really big, and now he's like toned down a lot. But like, I think he actually looks better now. He's just perfectly zipped up.
I feel like because of my shoulder, I feel like I have Jericho's chest.
You don't have Jericho's chest.
Or like Kofi clean, Kofi.
I saw a YouTube thing, and it said like. Their chest is like that because of it's like something from their neck. I don't know how true it is.
Probably me. I probably have that.
Fuck, can I tell a fucking meathead story real quick?
Yeah.
And tell me if I'm overreacting here.
Yep.
So like for me, like I have to get like 15, 20 minutes in on like the bike or some kind of cardio before I lift weights now because I'm just like lifting weights just does not feel good. It just fucking hurts. And I have to get warmed up. So I fucking hop on the bike. I'm on there for like a solid like 5 minutes. I totally thought you were going to fart to the microphone.
Put it past.
And he just put the microphone down between his legs to grab some water. Oh, shit. So I'm like on the bike for like 5 minutes and like this kid. Like, I had headphones in, and this kid obviously came walking up to me, so I took him out. I was like, hey, what's up, man? Like, I figured he was just going to ask me for some, like, workout advice or something.
Yeah.
And he was like, hey, man, can you give me a spot? And I was just like, I don't know, like, just kind of, like, I was like, what? Like, really? Like, I'm fucking on cardio. Like,
you might see you spotting other people.
No. I, like.
Never saw him before?
I mean, it's not like I can't. Not like I do it all the time or anything. Like,
yeah, but you're in there with the dudes, like, sometimes.
I guess. I don't know. I feel like that, like, To me, like, I was like, yeah, just give me like a few minutes. Like, I did a few more minutes and I just went and spotted him quick and then I came back. But like, I was just like, fuck, like for real, dude? Yeah. Like, I don't know. Is that like a weird question, or was I?
I literally saw Wes throw a weight at a dude before because the guy came up and took his earbud out in the middle of like a press.
Yeah,
I think Paige just retired.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's like crying, and she just put like a shirt down in the ring and stuff like that.
Oh man, that's a bummer.
Yeah,
I don't know what else it could possibly be. Oh, that sucks.
Yeah,
I mean,
she got hurt.
Her neck's bad.
Yeah,
her neck is bad. What is she? She's like, is that 26? Yeah, is she?
I don't know.
Yeah, she's like
23, 24. 20s
at the oldest. That's crazy, man, for your neck to be that bad. But she has been wrestling since she was like 15 or something. So
yeah, I to go back to that.
Yeah, yeah. I remember this. Like, Wes was like doing a press, and some dude like pulled his earbud.
Pulled the earbud. Dude, we went to high school.
And what? Just started like talking to him.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Hey.
Fuck.
And he was like, "Dude, get the fuck away from me!" And then threw a weight at him. Threw like a 25 at him.
Yeah. Just frisbeed it at him. Yeah. Well, that's pretty bad. I don't know. Yeah, that just if the young brother that did that is listening. I gave you a spot, but man, that was, I don't know. That just was weird to me.
Bad etiquette, man.
It's weird. Weird etiquette.
Yeah. Were there other people in the gym?
He was actually working out with another guy, but like I think he was kind of like a smaller kid. He did. He had like 4 plates on each side of the hammer strength press machine. So like,
killing it, man.
Sure, man.
On a hammer strength machine?
Yeah, flat bench hammer strength machine. I almost wanted to talk to him because I saw him like flat pressing like earlier in his workout.
Yeah.
And it's like, bro, you don't need to do barbell flat bench at the beginning of your workout and then a hammer strength flat press at the end of your workout. Like, you're just blowing your shoulders out.
I do 4 workouts for my chest.
4 exercises? Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, I think I did 3 or 4 today.
You switch them up.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, switch up the exercises, the fucking, or the reps.
I got Danny on 5-3-1.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I saw Danny at the gym today, like, when I was leaving.
Yeah.
And I was, like, I was real proud of him because he just had some, like, short shorts on.
Yeah.
With his, like, perfectly, like, shaven, like, legs, like, hanging out. He's all tanned up, like, just looking like a total wrestler.
Awesome.
It's great.
Danny's great.
he gets it, man.
Danny might be the most ruthless person I've ever met.
He loves bullying bullies.
He's not
a dick. He just you're shitty to somebody else, he's gonna be real shitty.
He's
to you.
So ruthless, man.
Yeah, he
just doesn't give a fuck.
He goes hard.
Yeah, I love it.
It's great.
The other day me and him went through a back workout or whatever like that, and it was like he's just a sponge. It's crazy.
Oh yeah,
like he just gets everything.
Well, because when you he listens when you talk too. You know what I mean? He could tell. Like, he really, Daniel Garcia's the Red Death, Daniel Garcia. He's got some new tights too. We ordered. They look fucking sweet.
Yeah, those things look awesome.
Yeah, he's one of the Buffalo Brothers. He's definitely a dude to watch, man.
Yeah, he's gonna be awesome.
Yeah,
he's so young too.
It's insane.
19.
He has not even 21 yet, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Good shit. What time we got?
I don't know. What time you leave? Because Laura's coming in.
She's landing. It's 9:33. She lands at 9:50. So I think she was even delayed a little bit too.
Okay.
So we got time.
I gotta text Puff and let him know that I'm gonna go see this movie with
you. Go see Blockers.
I don't know, man. Like, we're leaving.
I think I might actually pack tonight.
I kind of just want to be not at a movie. Like, I was gonna go see it tomorrow during the day. I have my pre-surgery doctor's appointment tomorrow.
Yeah, they just check out.
They do EKG.
For your heart, right?
Yeah, they do an EKG on you to see if your heart beats right. And then, like, I just had blood work done. So they tell you, like, if you're, like, in need of shit. Or if you're, like, if I'm, like, I don't know, close to hypertension, they can't do the surgery on me.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, like, shit like that.
They just got to make sure you're like, suitable to go on.
Yeah,
pretty much.
For sure. But that's at, like, 11:20. So
yeah,
I was thinking maybe seeing... There's like a 2:00 showing or something.
Blockers
like that.
After
Blockers.
That. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not in bed.
Do we know what time we're flying?
No. I didn't want to bother Laura about it because I didn't get any info yet.
Me neither.
I didn't want to bother Laura. I just remember we get into California at like 8:00 at night, I think.
Yeah.
So like, I think we leave. We're not leaving at like the crack of dawn. I think we leave at like afternoon time.
Okay, cool.
So we probably got a layover somewhere.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't think I have an email from him. Maybe he sent it to Laura. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I didn't get an email either.
Yeah. Well, but it's cool that we got time to fucking hang while we're there.
I'm pretty pumped.
Yeah. A couple big announcements coming. Good shit's on the horizon.
Yeah. We can announce there's something enormous that we're kind of like holding back. I mean, it's not as big as Kevin Bennett's baby. But there's big news.
Pretty cool.
And we have to announce it, but we're not allowed to announce it until after we do it.
Yeah.
So So Thursday,
it's going to be rad.
At noon, me, Jesse, and Laura are doing one of the coolest things you can do in wrestling. And then we'll be able to announce it when we walk out of there at like 2-3 o'clock.
Yeah. We'll let you guys know ASAP.
Yeah.
You know, fuck, this just popped in my head. By the way, everybody, we have a Twitter, Kickin Ass Pod. Our Twitter has like 400 followers. We can really use some followers.
Yeah.
What pissed me off was like Laura launched the Demon Bunny thing.
Yeah.
They got 1,000 followers in like less than 48 hours.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, our Twitter has like barely 400 followers. Please, guys, if you could, our Twitter is at Kickin. With no G, KICKIN SASS pod, POD. Give us a follow on Twitter, please.
POD.
POD, Kickin Ass Pod.
That's a bunch of stuff that's going on. I really can't wait to announce it. And I know, like, what we're doing right now, like, kayfabe or whatever, we're filming or we're recording this right now, and it comes out Thursday.
Yeah, the day of bar wrestling.
Yeah.
So, oh, yeah, and the day we do cool-ass shit.
Yeah, so, like, I feel like we can announce it, but we can't.
I'd pump the brakes a little bit.
Yeah.
But, yeah. So, if that gives you more reason to follow us on Twitter, because we'll put it up as soon as we can.
Yeah.
And then, Laura did just text me. She's landing in 15 minutes, so.
Okay.
This should probably jet.
Yeah. Hey, oh, guys. Yeah. Let's talk about a little nutrition thing real quick.
Uh-huh.
Anyone listening that is vegan or vegetarian or trying to do a dairy-free thing, start fucking with nutritional yeast. Nutritional yeast is...
Were you talking to Laura about this? I heard you talking to somebody about it.
Wes with his girlfriend, Cass.
Okay. You were talking to somebody. Somebody was saying they use nutritional yeast on, like, everything. I think it was Wes.
Like popcorn.
Right. Yeah.
It's like, it's seriously cheese, but it's not cheese.
Yeah.
It's unreal.
Really?
It's the best.
Fuck.
And I've been doing this thing.
Like, what's it like? So, what's the nutritional value in it?
I don't know.
Just good for
it. Really good. It's for your brain, brother.
Yeah, fair enough.
She'll make like vegan Parmesan cheese.
Yep. That's exactly it. Yeah.
Oh, so it's like healthier than cheese?
You can make a cheese out of that and cashews.
Okay.
She does. Yeah. She blends it all up, puts it on pasta.
It does sound pretty fucking good.
It's so nice, dude.
For real?
Yeah. That was one of the things I bought at Whole Foods.
Oh, really?
That chicken bone broth.
They have bone broth there?
Oh, yeah.
Where, like, what, is it a drink or what is it?
No, it's just bone broth. Like, you would use it for a soup.
But, like, are you going to make soup or how are you going
to
drink
it? You can add it to your meals.
Okay.
You can actually, like, just.
Doesn't Matt Vincent put in his coffee in the morning or something? Or he drinks it, like, separately or something?
Yeah, I mean, you can, like, you can cook it like a tea. You can, like, steep it and, like, drink it that way. But you can also, like Stan Efferding made that, like, Monster Mash stuff.
Yeah.
So it's, like, his Monster Mash is, like, it's like rice, rice, carrots, bone broth, whatever protein you want to use.
Yeah.
He usually uses red meat, though.
Yep.
Like ground red meat. Orange juice.
Yeah.
You dump orange juice in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's just for flavor or if there's like a reason for it.
There is a reason for it. Like everything that's in it, it's basically the vertical diet. That's what it's called.
Yeah.
And the vertical diet is like instead of like branching out into like doing... Hey, I'm going to do chicken and it's going to be, and I'm probably getting this way wrong. I'm probably butchering it. So it's like my science in my head, why it's called vertical is because it's just like, it's exactly what you need. There's no deviation of it. So like, it's essentially what you do, but like they just put it all in one thing. They make a mash.
Yeah. Big mash
out of it.
It does sound pretty good.
Sounds awesome. And I've been doing this one thing where like I bought just that leafy salad, right?
Yeah.
That we had the other day. We had that leafy salad, the spring mix or whatever bullshit. I put all my ground turkey in the bottom of it.
Yeah.
And then I make the salad on top of it.
Yeah.
I add hummus to the turkey.
Uh-huh.
And then on top of it, I use those glazed walnuts.
Yeah.
And then the cranberries.
Yeah.
None of it stays in the leaves. So it just kind of like gets all the stuff and drops into the turkey.
Yeah.
And turns into this like rad Thanksgiving thing.
That's
there's like
sweet.
Cranberries
yeah.
and walnuts and like
that sounds awesome.
Today I put some nutritional yeast on it. It yeah. was like insane.
That's fucking great.
I haven't stopped thinking about it.
Yeah.
Since I did it the first day.
I think I might take a trip to Whole Foods. I didn't think about that for bone
yeah,
broth.
Just be careful.
What do you mean?
Just
oh yeah, financially.
You might leave $100 off.
Yeah, deep.
Lashley's gonna smoke fucking
shit.
Eli.
Lashley's on. Who's in the ring?
It's walk with.
Oh, Elias.
Eli, I just said.
Sorry, guys. We're going to mark out here because Bobby Lashley just came back.
Yeah. He looks fucking massive.
How yeah.
A human being look like that.
Elias is my favorite part of Raw.
I love him.
Let's just fucking wrap it up.
Okay. Yeah, let's wrap it
up. Say goodbye to the brothers. Guys, thank you very much. You should take a picture.
Yeah.
We'll use that for the podcast this week.
Nah, that's not a guess. It's we a should shot. Take a, all three of us.
Okay, that's a good idea.
I still look shot. It doesn't matter.
All right, guys. Come see us at Bar Wrestling this week.
Yeah.
Outlaw Wrestling in Brooklyn following Friday.
And by the way, if you're listening to this and you're an ESW fan, I'll be at every ESW show.
Yeah.
I'll be at every Smash show. I'll be in the crowd hanging out with you guys. Come up. And talk to me about wrestling. Talk to me about music. Take pictures of me. I'm gonna be fucking
yeah. Big Butch
slung
is
up.
Big Butch is gonna be straight out of surgery, so he needs your help, guys.
Yeah, come hang with me.
Yeah, we'll see you soon, guys.
Yeah,
heat's in the ring, brother.
Hey, the heat is in the ring, brother. 1 year ago.
What?
1 year ago was heat in the ring, brother.
Yeah, yeah, because it was fucking from spring break last year.
Yeah.
Good call.
Yep.
Uh-oh, Lashley.
Yep.
Lashley's
doing stuff. Okay, we're out of here.
Eats the ring, brother.
Thanks,
guys. All
right, bye.